This is the Prusa i3, and in my opinion, it's the most iconic and influential 3D printer there is. It's reliable and so easy to fix and upgrade, and if you owned the original Mark 1 back in 2015, you could buy official upgrade kits to take it to the Mark 2, then the Mark 3, and all the way to the modern Mark 4. And that's why I love it, because it's a really solid pro-consumer machine. But that got me thinking about Prusa's other products. You might know of the i3 or the Powerhouse XL, but what about their more obscure products, like the AFS, Medical One, or whatever this is? There's a lot of history that I had no idea about, so I've summed up every Prusa 3D printer ever made into this mostly factually accurate video, and I guess I'm ranking them based on their vibes too. So let's start in 2010 with the Prusa Mendel. It was a remix of the existing Mendel RepWrap project, but designed to be easier to both build and modify. And yeah, this is just what consumer 3D printers looked like in the early days, and you'd politely ask a friend to 3D print all the plastic parts for you, then you'd try to find the rest from hardware and hobby shops and assemble it all yourself. In 2011, a lot of the parts were redesigned to be more uniform and include push-fit components, just some small quality of life improvements before this, the Prusa Mendel i3 in 2012, which should be looking a bit familiar at this point. This version is a complete redesign with a new solid frame, and early versions of this frame were mostly laser-cut acrylic or CNC'd aluminium, but people were even making them out of wood, and every 3D printer was unique, because there was no official kit you could buy, right? These were just designs that you could replicate. And up until this point, Prusa was just one person, but in 2012, Prusa Research was established and became many people. They cooked for a few years and then released the original Prusa i3. Now it was extra refined and you could buy an entire kit with proper instructions, support, and a warranty. The custom Prusa nozzle, however, was designed for 3mm filament, but it quickly became apparent that 1.75mm filament was going to become the norm, and just a few months later, an updated version with an E3D nozzle for 1.75mm filament was released. It came with a rigid aluminium frame and iconic Prusa orange 3D printed parts. The naming is a bit weird around this time, but we'll call this the Mark 1 and the previous version the Mark 0. These designs were such a monumental step for consumer 3D printers that just 6 months later, the i3 was the most used 3D printer design in the whole world. So in 2016, they decided to push it even further and create the ultimate i3 design, the Mark 2. It had a 30% larger heated bed, PEI print surface, full mesh auto bed leveling, refined parts, better extruder and firmware, and overall faster speeds. But if you'd purchased the Mark 1 the previous year, don't worry, because Prusa also started selling upgrade kits that include just the new components to upgrade your Mark 1 to a Mark 2. These features and the upgradability really did result in the ultimate i3. Well, until the Mark 2S came out the following year. This one was mostly just a reliability update with better bearing and probe mounts that were apparently less prone to breaking, and also better strain relief for the cables. And of course, an upgrade kit was available if you wanted it. It really was the ultimate i3, until the Mark 3 came out the following year. Now, this is the 3D printer. It added a filament sensor, a more rigid frame, better sensors, a magnetic heat bed, and PEI powder-coated print sheets. And also, you could now slap a Raspberry Pi into the motherboard to get remote printing and monitoring. These features are all pretty standard on 3D printers today, thanks to the Mark 3, which is probably the reason why the Mark 3 still holds its weight today. If you can find a secondhand Mark 3 for a good deal, it's worth it, unlike a lot of other 3D printers of that era that you should probably avoid. And of course, you could buy an upgrade kit from the Mark 2 or Mark 2S, but for the first time, the Mark 2.5 upgrade was also available. It's exactly what it sounds like. It'll take you halfway from a Mark 2 to a Mark 3. It didn't upgrade the frame or motherboard, but you did get a magnetic bed, improved extruder, a bed leveling sensor, filament sensor, and it also added support for the MMU. The multi-material upgrade allowed you to print with up to 4 different colors by automatically switching between them. Now, I've only used the Prusa MMU once in my life, so I'm not really qualified to talk about it, but when I did use it that one time, it was impressive, especially in 2017. The problem though is that it didn't seem to work as intended very often for a lot of people. If you do a quick search about what people think of the original MMU, it's not great. In fairness, people who had a good time with it probably didn't feel compelled to talk about it online. But regardless, the MMU2 was quickly released the following year to try to fix all the issues. And to my knowledge, there wasn't an MMU to MMU2 upgrade, but it could now do 5 filaments, had a direct drive motor, completely new electronics, a filament cutter, manual controls, print recovery support, and a much improved feed system. But at the price of being super bulky. And while it was a massive improvement, the consensus remained as it's awesome when it's working. So the following year, the MMU MMU2S was released to try to fix all the issues. This time, everyone who had purchased an MMU2 got the upgrade kit sent to them for free. With a few extra changes, this time Prusa boasted of a 93% success rate for multicolor prints. 19% of those required user attention to finish, but whatever, it was an improvement and it was free. The MMU was a product that probably launched before it was ready. But if it never launched early, would it have improved so rapidly? And considering that other companies are still struggling with making their own multi-material systems today, Prusa was definitely ahead of the curve. But I'd love to hear your thoughts on the MMU in the comments below. Prusa now had a heap of products and upgrades available, and this is where things started getting a bit confusing. When you have a Mark III or Mark 2.5 and order the MMU2S, you're getting the Mark 3S slash Mark 2.5S upgrade. MMU2S is MMU2 plus Mark 3S slash Mark 2.5S upgrade plus filament buffer.
Huh?
But anyway, next up in 2019 is the release of the SL1 and CW1, their first resin printer. The CW1 is their matching washing and curing station, and online consensus at the time was that it works great, but she was expensive. And that's also a reason why I don't see many Prusa products here in Australia, because when you convert currencies, add shipping and the import fee, products just aren't priced competitively here. There's also no official reseller, so if you want to buy one locally, you're going to get an even worse deal. But what isn't a bad deal is PCBWay. They're my go-to for custom 3D printing that I can't do in my own workshop, like this clear resin phone case that came out perfect, or this aluminium 3D printed brick mouse from a previous video. And they also do CNCing. They helped out with making the metal parts of my wallet here, plus of course they do custom PCBs if electronics are more your thing. Their 10th anniversary sale is happening right now until the end of the month, and if you want an extra $5 off your first order, check out my special link below. Their website is super simple to use. Just upload your file, select what process, material, and color you'd like, then PCBWay will review your order for any issues and send it out to you when it's done. And thank you to PCBWay for being a continued supporter of my channel. Cheers. Next was the Mark 3S and Mark 2.5S. Small updates that just added a better filament sensor, better cables, and some new 3D printed extruder parts. But then came the Prusa Mini, which had all the best parts of the Mark III, just smaller and cheaper. It also introduced a color LCD screen for the first time, something its big brother didn't have. And the Mini Plus was released the following year, which improved the auto leveling by adding the Super Pinda sensor. And the Mark 3S Plus was also released the same year, which added the same sensor, but it was mostly just a small update that improved reliability somewhat and made it easier to assemble. The next release was the SL1S Speed, which was actually quite a substantial upgrade with a 25% larger build volume, a higher resolution and much more durable display, and it was also around 400% faster than the previous model. And the CW1S was also released alongside it, with only some minor updates. Okay, next up in 2021 was Prusa's first Core XY 3D printers being announced. Well, actually 9 of them, strapped together into what they called the AFS, Automated Farm System. The arm delivers finished prints into the storage section, and then swaps in a new plate so the printers can start working again. And this means you can produce parts 24/7 with minimal human interaction, and it can also be expanded in increments of 9 if you need that. They've shown this thing off at a few trade shows, and as of 2023, there are several companies that have an AFS which is set to start at $50,000. Also in the same year was Prusa's acquisition of Trilab, and they added the existing Delta Q and Aztec Q 3D printers to the Prusa store. They're not really Prusa 3D printers, but I'm adding them here anyway. 2022 was a quiet year with the Anniversary Edition Golden Mark 3S Plus being released, as well as some limited edition build plates. I wish I got some of these, but I missed out. And the official Prusa enclosure was also released, which is just a really solid enclosure with support for a filtration system, locks, and fire suppression. It seems like it was mostly designed for businesses or schools, and the price tag reflects that. Alright, 2023 was the biggest year for Prusa, with the Mark 3.5, Mark 3.9, Mark 4, MMU3, XL, HT90, SLX, and Medical 1. But starting with the Mark 4, it had completely new electronics, 90% of the parts were redesigned, it was like twice as fast as Mark 3S Plus, had remote printing, support for the MMU3, a much improved extruder, and a brand new color touch display. The Mark 3.5 upgrade took you halfway to the Mark 4, with new electronics, touchscreen, and improved print time. I actually did this upgrade in another video if you want to check that out. And the Mark 3.9 upgrade gave you the improved extruder as well, just not the improved X, Y, or Z access motors or the new frame. And for the MMU3 launch, well, it was a bit of a mess. The MMU3 for the Mark 3S Plus started shipping mid-2023, but because of a few issues with the MMU3 for the new Mark 4, it took almost an additional 9 months to begin shipping. And Prusa did a few dev diary blog posts on the MMU3 which goes into details about the challenges they faced, and if you're interested in engineering and product design, I highly recommend that you give them a read. The good news though is that when the MMU3 released, least it was an obvious improvement. And even though the Mark IV was a beast and the MMU3 was slowly clawing its way to 100% reliability, it didn't really matter because in 2023, other manufacturers had caught up. So Prusa dropped an atomic bomb and released the XL, a huge Core XY with 5 independent tool heads. What's more reliable than an MMU switching between 5 filaments? Having a separate tool head for each filament, that's what. I've had the pleasure of using the XL a few times, and the ability to switch not just between different colors, but different materials is a game changer. It also means there's no purged material, unlike other solutions. Oh, and by the way, if you're interested in picking up a Prusa 3D printer, consider using my referral code at Bryce so that we both get some bonus Prusa meters that we can redeem for filament or fun merch like this heatbed mouse pad. Thank you, and I've included some links below. 2023 was also the year Prusa Pro was announced, a sub-brand for more industrial 3D printers like the HT90, which shares a lot of similarity with Trilab's previous 3D printer, the SLX, an upcoming follow-up to the SL1S Speed, and the Medical One, a 3D printer for biocompatible resins targeted towards healthcare applications. And finally, in 2024, the Mini enclosure was announced, which is adorable, as well as the XL enclosure, which is uglier than I thought was even possible, but I'm sure it's extra functional. And finally, announced earlier this week is the Mark IVS. It now comes with a high-flow nozzle, has faster print speeds, improved print quality, better cooling, an optional app, plus it's compatible with their new hackerboard if you want to make custom accessories. I'm really excited to see what people do with this. Also, the screen cover is now injection molded instead of 3D printed, which almost feels a bit sacrilegious. Anyway, I'm putting this one all the way at the top. The Mark IV had a bumpy start, but I think we're back. And I think I've covered all of Prusa's main products, but we can't forget about their other stuff like Prusament, Prusament Resin, and digital offerings like Prusa Slicer and Printables, all of which continue to evolve. Oh, and also the Prusa Mendel I2S was jokingly announced for April 1st, 2021, which included extra loud operation mode, but we can ignore that. And for now, I think that covers everything. But what's next for Prusa Research? Let me know your predictions down below, and I'll revisit this video in a few years and see which of us were correct. My predictions are that I think the i3 design has had an excellent 15-year run, but it's really starting to show its age, so I don't really see a Mark V ever happening. A Mark IV S Plus might come along in the next few years, but I don't really anticipate any major updates. I think Prusa is definitely working on their i3 replacement, maybe called the Prusa i4, and it's probably a Core XY machine that borrows from the XL and the AFS machines. Or at least that's kind of what I'm hoping for. And apart from that, I think we'll see Prusa continue to fight for its place in the industrial 3D printer market now that the consumer 3D printer market is kind of flooded. But please let me know your thoughts down below, and make sure you check out the description for more information. Cheers.